And it's only because of the mercy of Allah that we expect paradise. We expect eternal life. We expect the good life in this world and hereafter. That's what we are working for. So that one starts from the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah the Almighty, when He created us as a mankind, He gave us His love. He gave His love to everybody without exception and without condition. And without you, expecting you even to return it as it is. Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expects you to love Him, but it is up to you as an individual. It's up to the decision you take. And it's up to that, because of that decision, that your merit will be based on your decisions. So that love which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us unconditionally is the one I am addressing, and there are dozens and dozens of verses in the Quran that tells us about this love, but in different ways. And in all that, we can take the conclusion that how can we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? But before we talk about how should we love Allah, we have to know how Allah loves us. And in order to know how Allah loves us, then let's know what Allah loves particularly. Allah has given us this love to everybody, be a kafir, mu'min, munafiq, whoever he is. Because it's a mercy, and the mercy of Allah is general. In the first part of the mercy is general. Then there's a specific one. And because of that, then there's a specific type of love to those who deserve. How can you become a member of those who deserve the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It is easy. You look at the Quran and you will get that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Allah loves this thing. Allah loves those who does such, anyone who does such and such things. Allah loves those who perform these things of activities. And on the other way, you hear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in the Quran, in many verses, Allah doesn't love those who does such and such things. Then you don't need any other explanation. It's only you try to become one of those who Allah loves, whom Allah loves them, by doing what Allah loves. So it means you endeavor always in fulfilling and complying the conditions of Allah, and doing whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, whatever pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so that you will come under the light of Allah. It is this way, for example, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves this thing, these kinds of actions, and doesn't love these kinds of actions. So He turns light on those of which He loves. So it's you who should come there and come under that light, so that you demonstrate yourself to the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In order to do that, you have to expose yourself to Allah by doing what He loves. And if you go to the other way, then that means it is you who doesn't want the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you are staying away from the love of Allah. So what is the benefit of getting or attracting the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It's obvious, we all know. You cannot give somebody that you do not love, or at least you are not happy with him or with her, you can't give them something as a human being. You can't welcome somebody to your own house and let them stay forever and enjoy there while you hate them, unless there's another type of circumstance. So take that example to Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you please him and he is pleased with your actions, he gives you his love. And when you get the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you deserve the paradise. That the eternal life, that's how you work for it. And with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you get that love, how that love can help you? Let's take, there are couples of verses that I have, but let me first cite one hadith. There are two main hadiths actually that came into the case of love of Allah to the mankind. And one of them is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in this hadith, إن الله إذا أحب عبدا نادى من في السماوات يا جبريل إني أحب فلان فأحببه. It is indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he loves somebody and he really fell in love, that's how I can say, he accepted that person and he loved that person, then what he does, he calls those who are in the heavens, the angels, specifically he calls angel Jibril. And when he calls them, he calls Jibril and he says, oh, ya Jibril, oh Gabriel, inni uhibbu fulan fa ahbibu, indeed, I love Mr. X and, or Y, or Miss Y and X, fa ahbibu, so you should love him. I love that person, so you should love them. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to Jibril. And Jibril will start also another announcement. He would say, and fanada ya ahl as-samai inna allaha yuhibbu fulan fa ahibbu. He will start his announcement calling all those who are in the heavens, the creatures in the heaven, and we all know the angels, but there could be many of them, because and وَلِلَّهِ جُنُودُ السَّمَاوَاتِ. So Allah has created so many things that we don't even know them, both in the earth and the heaven. And when Jibril calls them, he would say to them, Allah loves that person, particularly your name. And then you should love him or her. He is announcing that love to everybody, anyone in the heaven. And when that happens, then the فَيُحِبُّ أَهْلُ السَّمَاءِ. So those who are in the heaven would love him. And after that, يُوضُعُ الْقُلُوبُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Then that love will be sent down to the earth. So when you see somebody, when you get the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first, your love will be registered in the heaven, and it will be expanded there in the heaven. Everybody in the heaven will love you, and that love started from Allah. Then it comes down, Allah sends to the earth, and when it comes to the earth, that is when people would love you. Not necessarily those who are your relatives, but anybody would love you, because your love is registered in the heaven. So that's the first one. That's how your love is, you get dignity, respect, prestige, and highness because of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because you brought yourself in the light of Allah, and then you attracted that. So the love of Allah, which is so magnetic, cuts you, and you become one of those Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them. So what will you get even after that? Of course we know we will deserve Jannah, paradise. And that's what we are working for. But also, what else? Look for any other things. Let us look at the other hadith. And the other hadith that, which is Hadith al-Qudsi, and it's reported in Bukhari. It says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in that Hadith al-Qudsi, من عادى وليا لي فقد آذنته بالحرب وما تقرب إلي عبد مما افترضت به ولا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى إذا أحببته فإذا أحببته كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به وبصره الذي يبصر به ولسانه الذي يتكلم به ويده الذي يبدش به ورجله الذي يمشي به فإذا سألني أعطيته. The meaning is that من عادى وليا لي, anyone who become an angry or agony or enemy of ولي لي, Allah is saying, and the one who is close to me, ولي is like intimate friend, close friend. The one who is very intimate friend to me, anyone who hates that person, فقد آذنته بالحرب. I have already declared a war against him. So Allah declares war against that person. And that person is, he's facing the war of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because he irritated, he frustrated, he bothered someone who is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we see that, then Allah is saying, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدٌ مِمَّا فَتَّرَ. Anybody, my slave, my servant, always comes closer to me because of what I have ordained him. Because of the commandments Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, you are coming closer to Allah. That's if you fulfill it exactly the way it is, sincerely. And that's how you come close to Allah. And it is that one which can take you away from Allah if you do not fulfill it. Then continuously the hadith says, وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ. And it will be continuous that my servant will come closer to me because of extra activities, extra duties, extra tasks that he done, which are nawafil, the sunans. So the first one is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded you. You fulfill it, then you come close to Allah. When you are done that, then you do some extra work so that you get incentive because of extra hours that you have given to worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that will take you even closer to Allah. And when we are saying these deeds, and I'm not expecting that, because I have already explained in other khutbahs what the good deeds are, a'malu saliha, and what taqwa is, and what righteousness, all those things I have explained. So we should know that always the good deeds are not limited to the masjid. And not only that, you come to the masjid and prostrate and make ruku' and that is. That's one type, is worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you should know how you treat with other people is a part of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should know how you are generous, how you are nice to the people, how you donate, how you welcome others, and the sincerity, all those things are among top issues of ibadah, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not that you do the worst outside and you only come to the masjid and make dua. That is not enough. If you make dua and, for example, you are saying, oh Allah, forgive me, but right after that you will do the wrong things, that means you say, oh Allah, accept my repentance, but you do not even repent because you are doing the same things again. And it is for sisters, for example, she may come to the masjid, and when she is close to the masjid or even already in the masjid, then she covers her hair. And that is the time she dresses well. But as soon as she goes out, she dresses indecently. That means God is only in the masjid. So you should be ashamed to yourself by doing that. Indeed. Coming back to the hadith, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَلَا يَسَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى إِذَا أَحْبَبْتُ. He will keep coming closer to me because of doing extra works until I love him. When I cover him with my love, then فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُ كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَحُ بِهِ. Then I become his ears or his hearings that he hears with. Meaning, I will be with him by hearing. He will not hear bad things. He will be on the right things only. And وَبَصَرُ الَّذِي يَبْصُرُ بِهِ. And his sight, I will be in his sight and the eyes that he sees with. So he will see only the good things. And also Allah says, I will be his وَلِسَانُ الَّذِي يَتَكَلَّمُ بِهِ. I will be in his tongue. I will be his tongue that he talks with. So Allah will guide you to saying the good things, the right things, and your tongue will not accept to say bad things. And he would, Allah is saying, وَيَدُّهُ الَّذِي يَبْدُشُ بِهِ. يَدُّهُ الَّذِي يَبْدُشُ بِهِ. He would be in your hands that you are grabbing something or hitting something or doing something, then it is Allah who is guiding your hand. وَرِجْلُهُ الَّذِي يَمْشِ بِهِ. And his leg that he is working with. In all that, Allah is with you. And Allah says, if he does alani a'daytu, and if he asks me, then I give him. So you are in the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because you are covered with his love, then you are under his protection. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, the topic is that we should know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he created us, he gave us his love before we even asked him. So guess here, you are, for example, say you are a cleaner, or you are just a layman, or say you are even a beggar in the street, and the president of that country or the prime minister loves you so much, what do you expect then? And when he loves you, that love is not limited to him, but he would call all his cabinet ministers, parliament members, and all of the and top people, and would declare that he loves you, and he would order them to love you. So look at your position there. That's just a small country that you are in. What about the one who created you and the one who created the entire world and manages the whole world? So take that example. And again, look at these things, that you are in the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you are on the right track. There are those verses that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned what he loves in them. And among them, I will just pick up the last word of each ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says repeatedly in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَابِينَ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِدِينَ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Those are number one. Allah, indeed Allah loves muttaqin, those who are fearful to Allah, those who are righteous, those who are pious, those who are sincere, those who are faithful, those who are lawful, and those who are obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So those who always, whenever they are doing something, they are careful of what they are doing, whether it is right or wrong. Those are muttaqin. Allah loves them. But that is general. In details, Allah says, إن الله يحب المقصدين. Allah loves those who are just. Those who act justly. When they are talking, they talk just. When they are treating with people, they treat with just. Whether that, even if that just is against them. So those who are, who do everything in the fairly, justly, and rightly, then Allah loves them because they are muttaqeen. And Allah loves those, and Allah yuhibbu al-muhsinin. Allah loves those who do good deeds, muhsinin, those who are nice to the people, those who smile to the people, those who donate to the people, those who help others, those who are nice to everybody, good doers, righteous people are muhsinin, those Allah loves them. And Allah says again, إن الله يحب التوابين. Allah loves those who repent to Him, the repentance. Those who remorse of what they did and repent to Allah, Allah loves them. But that is if they fulfill the conditions of repentance. And Allah saying, إن الله يحب المتطهرين. Allah loves those who are clean, those who clean themselves. But cleaning, this cleansing, of course, the body is included. But number one is the spirituality. Mentally, you must be clean. Spiritually, you must be clean. And physically, you must be clean. And in all that, then you become clean, a clean person. And then that love which came from Allah, you are the one who is reflecting back to Allah. And that's how you become the love of, in the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But so in order to become in that, under that shade, or under that protection, under that light, you must be staying away from whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like them. So you dislike what Allah dislikes them. And what are they? Let me take an example of that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in the Quran. لا يحب الله الجهر بالسوء من القول. Allah do not love those who openly say bad words. Means first they started it, saying it secretly in hidden ways, but when it became so popular and everything is open in the community, they are saying it publicly, insult people, backbite people, and harass others, and use all kinds of swearing, those bad words. Then Allah doesn't love them. Allah says, إن الله لا يحب كل كفار أثيم. Allah do not love those كل كفار, anyone who denies, anyone who hides the truth, anyone who means he sees your good things but he hides them, and he sees Allah's truth and he hides them. So the one who is out of jealousy, out of selfishness, he doesn't want even to mention the good of the others, the good deeds that are performed by other people. And then what do you expect from the truth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He hides. That's what the kafir, the meaning of kafir is that. Allah doesn't love them. And Allah doesn't love a thief, the one who always commits crimes, the sinners and criminals. And Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الظَّالِمِينَ. Allah do not love those who are trans, those who are oppressors, the alimin, those who oppress others, assault others, and just say there's somebody here and you attack them, either physically or verbally. Then that is dhalim, the wrongdoers. Allah don't love them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُعْتَدِينَ. So Allah do not love those who are transgressors, those who go beyond the limit. Just say, for example, and this one should go to everybody, not always, and what I'm addressing to is both those who are spiritual leaders, the ulama, the sheikhs, and the laymen are always equal in the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So for example, you can see somebody who is using even the hadith that I've just recited, that Allah becomes his eyes, his tongue, his ears, his hands, everything. And when he asks something, Allah, so anything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will accept it. his prayers. And that person takes that on the other way around, exaggeration. And he says, because Allah loves me, and then and Allah accepts my prayer, I will make prayer for you, you give me this money. So he charges that. That kind of person is the worst, to tell the truth. Because, and the simple question you can ask that person is to say, because, listen, Allah loves you, and he gives you whatever you want, right? Why didn't you ask him to give you millions instead of you asking me to give you just like a commission of few dollars? That's very easy. So that person is lying. You yourself, you cannot say always Allah loves me. You cannot know that. That is exaggeration on the other way. So you must be always in the middle. Allah says, "Inna Allah la yuhibbul mufsidin." Allah do not like those who are mufsidin, the corrupted people. And Allah says, "Inna Allah la yuhibbul khainin." Allah do not love the cheaters, those who cheat others, and those who deceive the people, and those who try to deceive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah, inna Allah la yuhibbul fasad. Allah do not love the corruption by itself. So all those things, you must be staying away from all these deeds, which are all of them mentioned in the Quran. Yuhib jahl bisu, that you say something bad out loudly, publicly. And kulla kafar, to be hiding something in the truth or so, or denying. To be a thim, to be criminal or sinner. To be zalimin, oppressor. To be a mu'tadin, transgressor. And to be mufsidin, corrupted person. And to be a deceiver, and to be, and to work something on corruption. Those are now, I have mentioned eight. And the opposite are to be muttaqin, to be mutadahirin, to be tawabin, and to be al muhsinin and muhsidin. You only follow this. Here is one line, and here is another line. So it's up to you which way you follow. It's very clear. That's how you can get the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. ولاقوا السلام.